डू यू नो द आईपी एड्रेस ऑफ गूगल और विकिपीडिया सर्वर? योर आंसर इज नो इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस. इन कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स यू रिक्वायर्ड आईपी एड्रेस ऑफ सर्वर टू गेट द रिसोर्सिस लाइक HTML pages, images, etc. to your machine. So the question is how we connect to web server with the human readable host names like google.com, yahoo.com or wikipedia.org without remembering numbers. This role played by DNS or domain name system. Domain name system act as the phone book for the internet for translating human friendly computer host name into IP address. So when your computer doesn't know the IP address of google.com, then it connects to domain name system and it search the IP address of your requested website google.com and give it to your machine. After getting IP address of google.com, your computer can request to Google server to access the web page. The DNS system is not managed by single computer, but there is hierarchy of such DNS servers working together systematically for this domain name to IP address translation. So let's see how it works. The DNS hierarchy contains level such as root level, top level domains, second level domains, subdomains, and host. The DNS root is the highest level in the DNS hierarchy tree. It answers the request for records in the root zone by providing servers for the appropriate TLD, top level domain. The root DNS servers are operated by different organizations like VeriSign, University of Southern California, Internet System Consortium, ICANN, and many more. In next level in the DNS hierarchy is top level domains, which are classified by organizational and geographic hierarchy. For example, COM for commercial organizations, EDU for educational institutions, GOV for government institution, NET for major network support centers, ORG for non-profit organizations. There are many such TLD server available under the root DNS server. The next level in the DNS hierarchy is the second level domains. This is the domains that is directly below the TLDs. Second level may have a subdomain. The subdomain is the next level in the DNS hierarchy. Like for google.com, we have two or more subdomain like policies.google.com and support.google.com, etc. So let's take one example to understand the domain name system. When you open a web browser and write www.example.com in address bar and press enter, the query travels into the internet and is received by DNS recursive resolver, which is typically managed by your internet service provider, ISP. The resolver then queries a DNS root name server. When resolver asks the root server about IP address of example.com, root server responds, "Hey, I don't know the IP address of example.com, but I know the address of TLD server of .com." The root server then responds to the resolver with the address of TLD server for .com. The resolver then makes a request to the .com TLD. The TLD server then responds with the IP address of domain's name server. It's also called authoritative name server. Finally, the recursive resolver sends a query to authoritative name server. The IP address for example.com is then returned to the resolver from the name server. The DNS resolver then responds to the web browser with the IP address of the www.example.com. Once the 8 steps of the DNS lookup have returned the IP address for example.com, the browser is able to make the request for the web page. Now the browser makes HTTP request to the IP address. The server at that IP returns the web page for example.com and rendered in the browser. And you can see the page of www.example.com in your browser. If you want to get IP address of any such website, you can use tools like NSLookup. To open NSLookup, click Start button and go to Run and write NSLookup. You can open this from command prompts also. Then you write google.com. And you can see here the IP address of Google. Here it is available in formats like IPv4 and IPv6. And if you type wikipedia.org, then it's also give the address of wikipedia.org. So I hope you understand how DNS works. Thanks and bye-bye. If you like this video, press like and subscribe the channel and share the video. And don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thanks for watching.